See ya. Okay, fine then. See, I have 1 second, guys. Okay, I think the slides are shared. So suppose if you have any points to be asked, so you can drop me a text in the chat box. Okay, so I last class we're done with. 1 second, guys. First of all, I would like to beg your pardon because because of some work, I could not engage the class on time. Last class, we're done with reading comprehension, right? And then vocabulary development, then reading comprehension. We are done with that. Okay. So today's session. Let's start with phonetics and pronunciation. So I think a few of you will be very much familiar with this topic, and few are won't be familiar with this particular topic. So here. Let me tell you very frankly that to understand the unit of sound or how it has to be pronounced and all, it takes little time. But trust me, it is not something which is very difficult to understand. It is very simple, one thing is that you have to practice a lot, and then you have to understand it in a proper sense. So this topic, I have made my mind to go slow, okay, to teach you slow, okay. So if you if you feel that I'm going fast, or if you feel that you're not able to catch, please ask me to stop, and then we'll discuss about this, and then we can go ahead with this topic, okay. So phonetics and pronunciation. So you all know why pronunciation is very important, correct? So in the last classes also, I was talking about the wrong pronunciation. How do we mispronounce the words, right? So why pronunciation that we have to take care of? Because if you're talking to people, and then if you pronounce it in a wrong sense, people will definitely laugh at our language, isn't it? Like if you pronounce your mother tongue in a wrong way, right, people will definitely laugh at us, isn't it? For example, minor mistake also people will laugh, isn't it? So in English also pronunciation is very, very important, and to understand that we should have little knowledge about phonetics. So what do you mean by phonetics? Phonetics deals with production of speech sounds. See, when we speak, right, we do produce sounds, right? We humans produce sounds. Phonetics deals with production of speech sounds by humans. often without prior knowledge of the language being spoken. So while everybody speaks, right, people will be master in their language. But the point is, are they aware of phonetics? No, not everyone, isn't it? Just because it is prescribed in your syllabus, we are dealing with phonetics. But I got to know, like, you know, we could be people. So now, when we see school books, right, you know, it is prescribed even for school students. But when we were doing school, we had zero knowledge about phonetics. And we, since we did English and, you know, we did English in masters, then, you know, this particular topic was introduced. So we all learned, probably I learned in my masters, right? So then I was feeling it was really tough to understand, but now I feel it is fine, it is cool. So I tried making it a more simplified version to reach you people, okay? So let's go very slowly about this particular topic. Phonetics deals with the production of speech sounds by humans, often without prior knowledge of language being spoken. So forget about the rest, half part of the second half part of the definition, but understand production of speech sounds by human. Phonetics deals with production of speech sounds by humans. So what do you mean by phonology? So the ways those sounds, right? Phonology deals with the ways those sounds are organized in a particular language, right? So phonology deals with the ways those sounds are organized in a particular language. So phone, what does it mean, right? Sound. Chicks, scientific or systematic study of something. Phonetics means general study of all human speech sounds and how they are produced, transmitted, and received. So phonetics, when you break this word into two pieces, you get phone, right? So that is sound. Chicks means systematic or scientific study of something. So when you try to study this sound produced by human beings scientifically, then it is called as phonetics. It is the general study of all human speech sounds and how they are produced, transmitted, and received. The three things, right? How it is produced, how it is transmitted, and then received. So it is a systematic study of, you know, sounds produced by humans, right? Human speech sounds are, you know, studied in a systematic way called as phonetics. Clear? So now the question is, why the study of phonetics is important, right? I don't know which. So the point here is why we have to study phonetics, why it is important. So one thing, basically, we should be knowing the knowledge of phonetics. It is must for a learner of the English language, right? So which are the language that you read? You should be knowing the sounds first. You should be having little knowledge about sounds. Great. So the knowledge of phonetics is must for the learner, for any learner for that matter, of the English language, right? And then why it is, I'm particularly saying the English language, because we are focusing on the English language. We are not, working on the phonetics of other languages, right? So we are working on the English language right now. True description of sounds, right? Of English and how they are made, right? We should understand true description of sounds of English. For example, I have explained you in other classes, like how do we mispronounce the words, right? For example, no, we say luggage, age. No, it is wrong pronunciation. It is luggage, luggage. Okay, so then cabbage, we say it is wrong pronunciation. It is cabbage, right? It is cabbage, right? We don't stress on the syllable a there. Okay, and then to differentiate sounds of English from those of the mother tongue, we have lot of influence of mother tongue on English, because English is an acquired language, right? It is not our mother tongue, correct? Since Britishers ruled us for so many years, and then we came to a level wherein we ought to learn English for the administrative purpose and then to survive in this world. And today it has become the global language, just since so many people cling on to that particular language. So it is very necessary for us to earn our bread and butter, right? But what happens, since it is not our mother tongue, our mother tongue influence will be more on English. Sometimes when we have to translate, right? So we don't translate, but we transliterate, right? What does it mean, transliterate, right? Whatever the word you have spoken in your mother language, exactly you are bringing the same substitution in English, but the sentence structures will be different, isn't it? The sentence structures will be different from each language, so you cannot translate the same way how it is written in mother tongue or vice versa. Hence, translation is a very difficult task, correct? So you have to take the exact meaning. You have to bring a word which talks about the same meaning, and then you have to write in a structure where the meaning stands the same, right? The structure will be different, but the meaning should be same, correct? From the other language. So if you have knowledge about phonetics, right, then you will be aware of sounds, how it has to be produced in English language, and you can avoid the influence of mother tongue on your language. For example, asked, right? It is asked. But sometimes people or students, they produce that speech sound as asked, d. That particular last syllable is not required. It is not required, isn't it, right? So, and then say for example, when it comes to Kannada, we have a lot of mother tongue influence on English, right? For example, while talking about, for example, this is a pen, right? While speaking in Kannada, we add U sound for every English letter, a word, right? Pennu, right? Then when it comes to phone, we say phonu, right? When it comes to book, we say bookku, right? So this is a kind of influence, correct? So to avoid these things, one should have little knowledge about phonetics, and that is very important. So now, what do you mean by sound? Basic unit of sound. So in under phonetics, we'll be dealing with sounds, right? And that is nothing but basic unit of sound, phoneme, right? So the basic unit is called as phoneme. See, look at here, k, e, a, a, right? So it is the basic unit of sound, phonemes, right? And then phonetics is very important. And then phonology, it is a systematic study of human speech sounds. And then now here it comes the organs of speech. How do we pronounce the sound, right? Where the sound comes from, the speech sounds, right? It is only from here, correct? Only from neck, right? So the sound is produced in vocal cords, yes or no? And then it is transmitted through larynx and pharynx, and then it comes to your mouth, and then you modify by using your teeth, your lips, your tongue, right? And then nasal cavity, right? So by using all these minor organs in the body, right, we produce sounds. So let's see the organs of speech here. First thing, see, look at the lips, right? Pa, ba, ma, right? So we use lips, isn't it? So you have a pair of lips, that is lower lip and upper lip. Then the other sounds, for example, ta, ta, right? So they, you use dental. See, these sounds are dental sounds, and it is produced by it is produced with the help of teeth, and also you have upper teeth and lower teeth. Okay, let's keep this apart. And then you have tooth ridge, right? And then in that tooth ridge, you have back part, and then you have front part, correct? And then you have jaw. Then see here it is vocal cords. So where this sound is produced, is my voice audible, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So if you find any disturbance, you can just let me know. Okay. Yes. So now, so first let's work on vocal cords, right? You have vocal cords here, and then okay, so let me talk about the right section of the diagram here. So you have got lips, upper lip, lower lip, teeth, upper teeth, lower teeth, and then in teeth you have got tooth ridge, right? Back part and then front part. Then you have got jaw, and then here you have vocal cords. Now coming to tongue, right? So you have back part of tongue, middle part, front, and then tip of the tongue. Then you have got your nasal passage, right? Sometime near, na, right? So these are nasal sounds, right? So they, so we use this passage to pronounce those nasal sounds. And then you have got velum, right? So velum is the space between the nasal cavity and then the tongue. And then you have got nasal cavity, and then hard palate and soft palate. So the upper part of the ridge, right? So upper part of the ridge, you have got the hard palate and soft palate, right? About the tongue. So we use all these, what is that, organs, and then we use all the organs to produce the speech sound, right? So velum is also called as soft palate and then hard palate, and also these have a very distinctive role in producing human speech sounds. Is it clear? So in exam they may ask you the question that explain organs of speech. They may ask you for 5 minutes. Okay, so all you have to do is you have to write these diagram and then explain the role of it. Okay, and then now phonetic sounds in English. So you have got 26 alphabets, right? How many phonetic sounds that we have got? We have got 44 phonetic sounds. See, guys, beauty of the language lies in pronunciation. So if you pronounce the words in the proper way, right, obviously your language looks beautiful. If you fail in pronunciation, no matter how much language that you have got, but somewhere people may, you know, or may laugh at our pronunciation. So to avoid that, one should be thorough with pronunciation, right? And then 44 phonetic sounds. So how many vowel sounds that we have got? How many vowels that we have got? 5. But vowel sounds? 20. So under that, there are two different types, that is monophthongs. That monophthongs wherein we have got 12 just hold the one. So what I was, what is it? Vowel sounds, vowels we have 5, isn't it? A, E, I, O, U. The rest are called as consonants, right? So vowels we have 20, under that monophthongs 12, diphthongs 8, and the rest are consonant sounds. So let's see vowel sounds. I'm sorry, okay, so what do you mean by monophthongs? See, divide this word monophthongs. Mono means one, right? Diphthongs, D-I, di, 2, right? So mono means single. What is a monophthong? They will definitely ask you for 2 marks question. Monophthong, a vowel sound whose quality does not change over the duration is called as monophthong. Just hold for a minute.
Hello?
Huh? Hello, sir. Really, sir? Hi, sir. Adam, sir. Yes, sir. Sorry guys for the interruption. What is the time now? Okay, let me finish this one. Okay, what is a monophthong? Mono means single. Always remember this vowel sound whose quality does not change over the duration is called a monophthong. Right? I, right? It is E, E, A, U, right? So these are the only sound, right? One unit of sound, and it won't change. The same sound won't glide to the next sound, right? There are also called as pure or simple vowels. So how many monophthongs are there? Remember, monophthongs are 12. Okay, so what do you mean by diphthong? What is diphthong? Two. Di means two. Changes from one sound to another. The vowel sound that glides from one quantity to one unit to the other is called as diphthong, right? So your A, right? Your E sound and then I sound, right? A, A, I, right? O, right? There are different unit of sounds which glides from one to other. So how many diphthongs that you have got? Eight. So I'll continue in the next class. We'll repeat monophthongs and from diphthongs. Okay, fine. See, here you can take the attendance. And then if you have got any doubts, you can ask me now or the next class. Okay, is it fine? Tomorrow we'll continue with the same topic. Clear? Sia, did you take the attendance? Shall I end the meeting? Please, so today what did we learn? We learned what do you mean by phonetics, what does it mean in pronunciation, right? Why pronunciation is very important? Because the beauty of language lies in pronunciation. Okay, and then phonetics, production of speech sounds by humans, often without clear knowledge of the language being spoken. What do you mean by phonology? The ways those sounds are organized in a particular language. Phone means sound. Chicks, scientific study of something. Phonetics, general study of all human speech sounds. How it is produced, transmitted, and received. Okay, so the importance of phonetics you all know, and then sounds, basic unit of sound, or it is called as phoneme, right? Syllable, right? And then phonetics study, scientific study of these human speech sounds, correct? Phonology, right? It's a process of phonetics means when you divide this phone and text, it is the same, right? And phonology means the ways the sound produced or organized in a particular language. Like even they work on the dialect of the languages. And then you have got organs of speech and their importance, correct? And then how many sound letters are there? 26 letters. How many sounds are there? 44 sounds. And in that, there are two different, you know, these 44 sounds are divided basically in two ways. The first one is vowel sounds and the second one is consonant sounds. Vowel sounds, there are 20 vowel sounds. But how many vowels are there in letters? There are 5 vowels, A, E, I, O, U. But the sounds, 20. Under that, it is divided under the category monophthongs and diphthongs. And then you have got consonant sounds. So vowel sounds, you have got 20. Monophthongs, you have 12 sounds. Diphthongs, 8 sounds. Clear? Mono means single. A vowel sound whose quality does not change over the duration is called as monophthong. They are also called as pure, simple vowel sounds. E, E, right? So here, E, E. The sound didn't change. How many monophthongs? Remember, it is 12 monophthongs. And then diphthongs means 2. So what happens here? It won't, you know, stand same. It changes from one sound to another, right? The vowel sound that glides from one unit, one quality to another is called as diphthong, right? A, right? I, A. So you have got the sound got changed, right? From one unit to the other unit, another section. So it started gliding. So that is called as diphthong. So how many diphthongs you have got? 8 diphthongs. So see here. We'll continue in the next class. So, okay, fine then. We'll go slowly about, this particular topic. Okay. Okay, fine then. I'm ending the meeting since you have, your CR has already taken the attendance. Thank you guys. And please try to practice the, practice sounds, but it's okay. Tomorrow we'll finish the session, right? From tomorrow you can do it. Okay. Thank you.